Well, who could have seen it coming, eh? Well, everyone apart from Labour, I guess. Let's begin. It does make me question Labour's logic, this, and I don't mean to sound nasty at all, but when you have certain policies saying that criminals have to be freed early because, you know, we just probably don't have enough space in our prisons, obviously apart from the little fact, of course, that they certainly did when all the riots were going on, which makes me question why they even would have released people early if they did have those spaces available. It just doesn't make sense to me. Either way, though, something has just happened which is going to kind of make all this blow up in Keir Starmer's face. And I say that because according to this article, it says that criminals freed early are being sent back to jail after, wait for it, reoffended. Well, what a surprise. Perhaps if I'm this good at predicting things, I should have also played the lottery as well, eh? I mean, I could be sitting here a millionaire. Mystic Meg, eat your heart out, eh? And all this apparently is according to a watchdog. Chief Inspector of Prisoners Charlie Taylor said a quarter of prisoners freed from HMP Nottingham through the early release scheme were homeless when they left jail, resulting in inevitable recalls. And get this, he warned that high-risk offenders are not being given enough attention despite warnings about the danger they posed. Which, if you think about it, is just frightening, isn't it? Especially if these guys are also being released early, which obviously they shouldn't really be if they've committed a horrible or nasty crime to someone, surely. Apparently, prisoners were initially eligible to be freed 18 days before their conditional release date, but was increased to 35 days in March this year, and then to 70 days in May. So obviously, this was, at the time, the Tory government. But Labour do seem to be doing the same thing, and I say that because this article says that, wait for this, nearly 2,000 prisoners are set to be released on a single day. Just how mental is that? Especially when, of course, they've now been told that people who are released early are basically being recalled, either because they've reoffended or because they've broke their bail conditions or whatever. It just is absolutely mental, isn't it? Almost 2,000, it just doesn't bear thinking about, does it? And apparently, they're all going to be released on September the 10th. What might actually happen if indeed quite a lot of them are from the same prison? Surely, in that case, there could be a very high risk of the crime rate in that area kind of going up a bit, I suppose, eh? Apparently, it says the offenders are all serving sentences less than 5 years, have been identified for a first group of early releases on September the 10th, a second group of up to 1,700, all jailed for more than 5 years, will be freed on October the 22nd, just before Halloween, eh? And after the law was changed to allow them to be released after serving 40% of their sentences rather than the current half. And I don't know about you, but personally, that in itself I just think is absolutely disgraceful. What's the point in saying to someone, you have to go to prison for 10 years, and then actually find out, well, it's actually 4 years. I mean, 10 years sounds a lot better than 4 years, but if they're out in 4 years, then it's no better at all, is it? I mean, just think how the victims, if any, must feel knowing that not only to start off with they'll have to serve just half of the sentence, but now it's been reduced to much less. It's shocking, isn't it? Especially, of course, if they reoffend again. Because let's face it, if they were still in prison, then they wouldn't have done, would they, eh? It just makes me wonder if something awful may happen before Labour eventually does realise that. And I personally hope nothing awful happens at all. But let's face it, these guys were put in there for a reason, weren't they, eh? The move apparently comes after the Ministry of Justice activated emergency measures in the north of England on Monday to avoid running out of prison space in those areas of the arrests of rioters, increasing pressure on jails. Operation Early Dawn, as it's affectionately known as, a contingency plan previously triggered in May, forces police to hold suspects in their cells or release them on bail until a prison space can be found, rather than send them straight to court. I've got a better idea. Why don't they just build a few more jails, or maybe get their own jail version of a Bibby Stockholm, but for prisoners rather than asylum seekers, or legal boat people, as otherwise known, coming, of course, from the safe country of France. Even says here that the emergency scheme is designed to tide the prison service through to September the 10th, as the number of space places in male jails hovers between 300 and 500, which admittedly sounds quite a lot, although if it's spread out throughout the country, it more than likely isn't. But it continues and says it is understood that no single prison will release more than 100 prisoners on September the 10th. 100! That's just absolutely mental. Going out in one area at a time. And sources said the mass release would be staggered over the day. Oh, well, that's all right then, eh? I'll tell you what, we'll have a couple of breakfasts, a few more at lunchtime, and maybe a few more at dinner time, just to be safe. Although, personally, to me, it sounds anything but. The mass release scheme is required to enable all those eligible to be freed, including those who have already passed the 40% cutoff point, but who have not reach the halfway point. The same apparently will also apply on October the 22nd, after which any eligible prisoner reaching the 40% threshold will be automatically released, and it is estimated that the scheme will free up about 5,500 prison places over its 18-month operation. But thinking about it, what actually happens after the 18 months? Do they go back to releasing them at 50% of their prison sentence, or do they stick with the current, unfortunately, 40%. Or worse still, if prisoners do continue to get overcrowded, are they actually going to reduce it to, I don't know, 30%, 25%? I mean, it's just awful to think about, isn't it? People are obviously put in prison for a reason. And something like this, in my opinion, makes complete mockery of the situation. And in fact, it is quite worrying. Especially, of course, if the prisoners do actually end up committing another crime, which they wouldn't have been able to do if they were still in prison.